What's going on? My name is Mike Sarenstel. I'm a sophomore here at the University of Michigan, and I partnered up with Jamon Green to work on this action project assignment. You know, we really wanted to discuss, you know, the concept of community and how it related to COVID, because during this whole entire quarantine, we realized how much of a struggle it's been for, you know, the less fortunate places, you know, people who don't have as much wealth as others, you know, don't eat as much as others. How hard it's been for them to live during this time. So, you know, we really dove deep into researching on different ways to give back to community and just, you know, make life easier by donating, you know, doing speeches, you know, just going out and trying to make the community better and, you know, safer for everyone around. Also, speaking of the pandemic of COVID, another pandemic hit, I'm sure as you all know, Black Lives Matter, racism in the United States, you know. So one thing we also did for community, you know, is protesting, just making sure we could help as much as we can, you know, with the limited time we had being athletes, you know, having to move from campus back home, having to come back to campus. You know, just trying to do little things to help everyone around us and make community safe for everyone.
Hey, I'm Jamon Green, and during this whole quarantine, I've been doing a lot of community work with family and friends. I was donating money and food to the less fortunate, and it helped me be grateful for the things I have, because there's a lot of people that don't have nothing. I am looking forward to doing more projects like this, just to make a change in the world.
Hi, my name is Greg Brustein. I'm a teacher and a football coach at Everett High School in Everett, Massachusetts, and I want to take 2 seconds to talk to you about community. If community is the body of prosperity and progress within our society, then the people within that community are the heart and soul and blood that keep pushing it forward. We cannot be idle in making sure that we are doing everything in our ability to continue our community's growth. We have to be intentional and purposeful to make sure that our communities are constantly getting better. I am incredibly blessed to work in a culturally and racially diverse district where I've had the opportunity to listen and learn from my students, my coworkers, and my athletes. Our community needs us to come together and stand up for one another, particularly our Black community. Some of the most intelligent, hardworking, and just kindest young men and women I've ever come across need our help, and I will not stand by and watch them suffer. Edmund Burke is quoted as saying, "The only thing that it takes for the triumph of evil is for good people to do nothing." Now is not the time to do nothing. Our communities need us to unite to fight social injustice. I love all of the young men and women I've ever taught or coached. And when you love someone, you listen to them. And you do everything that you can to take their words and turn it into action so that you can help them further. Our communities can overcome this. Our communities can become stronger and more united than ever before, and it just starts with listening. I believe in doing good, I believe in good people, and I believe that our community and our country can find a way to end social injustice. Thank you.
The importance of giving back has its benefits. I mean, most especially, above all, is personally knowing the sense of satisfaction that comes in being able to help that next person survive the next day or even the day after that if they're in need of whatever support that they need help with. But aside from that, it builds community relationship. It builds a brotherhood, sisterhood. It just builds that rapport that you have with the next person, because in times of need, sometimes you feel that you're alone and that there isn't anyone out there that's willing to help you out. But when you do find that person that's whether it's close, whether it's distant, that's able to help you out, it gives you that next level of hope that you can survive that next day, and most importantly, that there is someone out there that truly cares about you, no matter who you are, no matter what the relationship is.
Hello, how you doing? My name is Carlos Ruiz. I'm currently a coach at Liberty Christian, and I was asked the question, why is it important to give back to your community? And I thought, what better example but to give you a little background on myself. You know, I was a young Hispanic boy growing up in a city that was, you know, it was made up of tough middle class citizens, and we were definitely the lower class. And I was going through some hard times growing up and some opportunities where I decided to quit school. And there were some coaches that came to my house and they refused to let me quit. They made sure I went back to school. They gave me examples of how I can better my life with school. And, you know, the life I live today, if it wasn't for those guys that went out of their way and, you know, helped me out, I wouldn't be where I am today. And what I've done in my life is go back to that school, that high school that I went to, Everett High School, you know, talk to the young men that are there, you know, and found different ways to be able to help them out through the different things that they're going through and help them reach some of the dreams that they're able to reach. And all I ask in return from those young men is not anything for me, but to just remember these moments. And when their opportunity comes and they're in a place where they can help somebody out, they need to do that. Because I believe that the community that you grow up in, that where you're from, that's what makes you who you are. And that's what drives you. And I believe that if you come from that community or whatever community it is that you come from, that you need to go and give back to that specific community, because there's guys just like you. There are guys just like me, and they just need that little push and that little opportunity so that they can see the light and just keep pushing, getting stronger, and you know, make something better of themselves. So, you know, I think about some of the stuff going on today, and man, that it's really hard to see, and I completely understand. Black lives do matter. I think it's an important movement. You know, I think of, you know, brown lives matter. You know, I'm a Hispanic young male. You know, yeah, I'm 39 years old, but you know, I've been through a lot of things growing up, and things have been, some things have been hard, but you know, I'm lucky because, I got a big nose and you know, I look like a white man. So I might have got some advantages that some of my other brothers, you know, they didn't get. So I completely understand the struggle, and I believe in equality because I think it's just it's sad to see some of the disadvantages that some of us have because we're from somewhere else. It's real, you know, and it's I think. A lot of the people struggle with it because, you know, they haven't experienced it, or they don't understand that it is real. But I think it's definitely real. But I think that's why it's even more important for you to give back to the community so that you can create opportunities for people that are in a lesser position. You know, I've been blessed to be in the position that I am, and I think that, you know, giving back is the best thing, because even though I live in Texas and ever, you know, is in Massachusetts, I still feel a lot of pressure to give back to that community, because it means that much to me. Because without that community, I would have never got to the heights or the places that I am today. So thank you for the question, and thank you for the time.